Yankee and a damn Yankee. The Yankee comes down to Texas and goes home, and a damn Yankee stays. Well, my name is Carol Kern, and I'm a damn Yankee. I grew up on a small chicken farm in a little farming community in western New York. There were more cows and chickens and pigs there than there were people. My work ethic was instilled by my father. I graduated from the Dick Kern School of Sweeping. When we were kids, we had chores that we had to do, and one of them was sweeping the floor. And it never failed. I was done, and he said, "You call that sweeping? Give me that broom." And he'd find a big old pile. I don't know where he picked it, but there'd be a big pile of dirt there. And he looked at me and he said, "If you do it right the first time, then you're never going to have to do it again."
Wow. Yeah.
So for the life of me, here I just thought to myself, man, is this as good as it gets, you know, following your father's advice. When I was in the seventh grade, we went into class and the teacher said to us, "Okay, well, what's your mother's maiden name?" She had taught my mother, my father, my aunts, my uncles, and I thought right then, I need to get out of this one-horse town. I'm not staying here for the rest of my life. So I decided, and my intention was to go to college, but my senior year, I fell in love with a boy named Duke, and he asked me to move to Texas, said he loved me, he'd take care of me, and I'd never have to work again. I was 19 years old, and I believed that with all my heart and soul. It was 1975, January, snowing, and we set off to Texas with $750 and a 67 Mercury with all our worldly belongings. I had one little plant that I brought with me, a ponytail plant. I still have that plant.
Wow.
I call it my husband. We got to Dallas and it had been raining for 3 weeks. And so we said, what are we gonna do? He was a heavy equipment operator and that's what we were gonna do. So he said, well, let's just follow 45 till it ends. So we followed 45 till it ended in Galveston, took a right, ended up in Surfside, Texas.
Wow.
It was the middle of February, it was 50 degrees, it was sunny, and I thought I'd died and gone to heaven. About 2 weeks later, Duke comes in, tells me, well, I just spent our last $110 on an efficiency apartment, we don't have any money, and you gotta go to work. So my fairy tale ended, and my journey began. At 21 years old, in the summer of 1976, I was living on Surfside Beach. I was a waitress at a marina, working 25 hours a week, making $500 in tips, and being a beach bum during the day. This was heaven to me. Well, seasons changed. October came, money was short, and we moved to Texas, or moved to up to Houston. In 1978, I began my postal career as a letter carrier for the United States government. In 1979, I married my prince, and then he turned into a grumpy old frog. We got separated in 81, divorced in 83, and my whole life, all I ever wanted was a house and kids. In 1984, I got what I wished for. I was a divorcee with a contract and a house, and I found out I was pregnant.
Oh, wow.
So, the joy of my life arrived in 1985. His name is Jacob. And then I wanted to stay home, but you know how that goes. You don't get to stay home. So, I saw this girl come to talk to us at work and said, oh no, you know, she had high heels and stockings and she was selling post office door to door, and I said, that's what I want to do. So I got on an express mail team. It was a detail thing, and I thought, man, this is what I want. Well, then we had another little surprise, and I had my E-team baby in 1987. I was up for a promotion, and they asked me how long I was gonna work because they wanted me to be a sales rep. And how long was I going to work up until my delivery? And I said, I'm going to work the day before. And so I decided at that moment that I was going to focus on my kids, and I chose not to take that. And I focused on my children. And then the path of my life kind of went up and down, up and down. My kids were my focus. And in 1996, as we all have things that happened in our life, I crashed and burned in my car. I only blew out a couple tires, but it was a moment that I chose to reflect on what the heck is going on here, where am I going? So, which leads me to divine order and the daily word. I was led by God to go ahead and focus more on my journey instead of my destination. That destination has led me to a full career, which I retired after 35 years, 9 months and 5 days. And now here I am in joyful retirement, experiencing Toastmasters for the second time. The last time I did this was 30 years ago, and I am hopeful. And I am also a damn Yankee who's happy to be here.